Welcome back to Daily Brunch with Ricardo. Joining us now is restaurateur Tony Kitous, who's here to talk about Lebanese food, and Sharon is with us too.
I'm just eating.
Now, I've got to be honest, over the last sort of few years, I find that Lebanese food I love more and more and more. It's become just so popular in the UK.
You know, one of the problems in the UK is the reason people didn't know about it, because not many restaurants or not many people were doing Lebanese food. But all of a sudden, few small entrepreneurs opening little restaurants, and all of a sudden people are getting to taste it for the first time. And the moment they try it for the first time, and a lot of them just get addicted straight away. It's a very simple food, very healthy.
So where does it all come from? What is the region that it encompasses?
Basically, the region, obviously, it's all about from the eastern part of the Mediterranean. You can take it from Syria, you can take it Lebanon, Turkey, Cyprus, Greece, and all those countries, they kind of borrow each other's ingredients and dishes, and it just becomes... Each country claims that hummus is Lebanese or the halloumi is Cypriot. But to be honest, it's all tend to be from the same region.
OK.
And so healthy nowadays, aren't we?
It's
just told this week
healthy.
That this is supposed to be a very healthy diet. Don't calorie count so much, just eat Mediterranean food.
It's healthy, it's simple, and it's... If you're a vegetarian, you're just in heaven. Yeah. And I eat this on a daily basis as part of my daily... for me, a lot of people don't know about Lebanese food. They think it's one of those food that is ethnic. But...
So what are we making, first of all? You've got a little demo for us before
today we're
going to
make labneh.
Yeah.
Labneh is strained yogurt made with sheep's milk or goat's milk. And this is the traditional way of making it. Personally, I would always recommend, if you don't want to make it at home, you can just buy it from supermarket. But today I'm going to show you how we make it at home. It's basically, we leave the yogurt strained overnight, and then we use it on muslin.
What sort of yogurt is it?
It's basically, it's a goat's, made out of goat's milk,
right.
Or it's just natural yogurt.
Right, OK.
And you can see all, whoops. And I can just put it back inside here.
Nice. Would you like to get rid of that for
it's all finger food as well, isn't it? Which is just you can dip into so many different types of tastes.
OK.
And basically, labneh, you can eat it in many ways. You can eat it with different ingredients. You can eat it with just with za'atar, you can just eat it with...
So za'atar's a little spice mix, isn't it?
Za'atar is this little spice mix made with ground wild thyme.
Is this it? Am I eating
This is, basically, this is with za'atar.
OK.
Try with this. Try with this.
Nice.
It's very simple. You can have this for breakfast, you can have it for lunch, you can have it just on a wrap.
Very good.
Love it.
Very good. Yeah.
Very good.
Might have to brush my teeth after I've eaten that.
No, you don't have to.
Very nice.
And today I'm going to show you one of the ways that you can make it. I make it with beetroot. I just chop some beetroot and get a little bit of tahina. You don't have to have tahina, but if you have a tahina, you can use some tahina, just a spoon. And I just mix it.
Well, while you mix that, we need to give your book a little plug. So this is full of your magnificent recipes and lots of good stuff, which is beautiful.
And can you get all this stuff in, like, a fairly normal supermarket?
Most of it is becoming more and more popular nowadays, so you can get a lot of things, you can get them in supermarkets.
All right. Now, listen, we're, as ever with these things, we're running out of time. So you're mixing up with the beetroot, but again, the labneh, once you've got the base, is then about kind of adding different things
exactly.
to it. Can we try some other bits and pieces while
you're mixing up? Of course
you can. So what is Timothy nibbling on there?
Basically, here is a small sojuk in pomegranate molasses. It's a spicy sausages that are delicious.
OK. Sausage.
Now, I've seen these many times in Lebanese restaurants. I've been in them.
Sweet and sour.
They're really
but
good.
The secret is how you make them. If you add a little bit of pomegranate molasses, it just gives that sourness and sweetness to the dish.
Very good.
That is delicious. OK. And what's next? What next should we taste?
I think you should now...
I'm just going...
You're just getting stuck
on my
in
own,
right?
Yeah.
I want you to test
what's
this.
What's this one down here?
The bread.
If you try this, this is menusha. Menusha for the Lebanese is what pizza is for the Italian. Have it with some mint.
You need some mint, Sharon.
Why? Stop my breath.
I don't want to say anything about...
What's on the top?
This is za'atar and black seeds.
No, underneath, so you've got za'atar on top, which you're
basically, this is a flatbread. You can do it with anything. You can make it with goat's cheese. You can just make it with just some labneh also. You can make it with just some sojuk.
But always, the whole premise of Lebanese food is about sharing.
Lebanese food, it truly is about sharing. It's all about sharing. It has been kind of food that people see it as kind of a fashionable food because it's sharing. But we've been sharing food for thousands of years.
Everyone likes to go to tapas bars now and sit there and kind of share just different types of things.
Mezze for the Lebanese, it's exactly what tapas is for the Spanish.
What is this?
I want you to try.
Very pretty pink one.
This is the turnips pickled in beetroot juice. Try this. Try a bit of halloumi and a bit of fix in rose syrup.
I didn't try the fix.
It's one of the most my favorite.
That's one of my favorite ingredients, rose water. I think it's one of the nicest ingredients.
I just love adding things to add a little bit of kickness to the flavor.
Glad I came hungry.
I want you to try some of this now.
Okay.
I'll make some for you. There you are. Sharon? I made you some crispy bread
so
with
good.
A bit of...
That's delicious with the...
It's
amazing, isn't it?
That's fantastic. I like it.
Gorgeous.
I really like that. Mm.
So not...
This is how mothers make food at home.
I just struggle with the whole sharing thing, though, because I like to know what I'm eating. I like to know which bit's mine.
Just really, everything is yours.
Do you do competitive tapas?
It's just that, you know, when the taps arrive, you think...
You have to win.
There's only three of us and there's four of them.
What do you like when you go to a restaurant with the lady and she decides she wants to try some of your plate? Are you like get off my food?
No,
the good things about Lebanese food, the Lebanese table, there's always a lot of food. You can never worry about maybe this will finish.
That's delicious.
And it's part of the hospitality.
It's very good. Though. I love this.
We've only just touched the surface on this. There's many things, more things that want you, but this. So thank you for coming on. Come back and teach us more stuff.
Thank you so much.